Hello everyone, welcome to Home Cooking with me, Hema Subramanian. During festivals and special occasions, we tend to make a lot of sweets at home. And today I'm going to share a wonderful sweet recipe with you guys. This is a very popular recipe, which is ghee Mysore Pak. Now, this is going to be so delicious and so soft and rich that it look and taste exactly like the ones you get in the sweet stalls. So why wait? Let's get started and check out the recipe. For the ghee Mysore Pak, first we got to roast the gram flour, that is the basin. For this recipe, I've taken 1 cup. This is a 250 ml cup. Keeping the flame on medium, just roast it till you get a nice aroma. So make sure you roast it on medium flame. You don't want to burn the gram flour. Roast it for about 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, the basin or the gram flour is toasted well. The raw smell is not there anymore, so make sure you don't have any raw smell after roasting it. Turn off the stove and keep this aside. Transfer the roasted gram flour or the basin. We're going to sieve this to avoid any lumps and you get a nice smooth gram flour. So next we're going to melt the ghee. For this recipe I've taken 150 ml of ghee. This is nice should desi ghee. Transfer the sieved gram flour or basin to another bowl. Now pour the melted and cooled ghee. Once the ghee comes to room temperature, just pour half of it. Just mix it all in. We're going to gradually incorporate the ghee into the gram flour. So you can see the basin mixture is nice and creamy and smooth. This is how we want it. Now keep this aside. Next, prepare the tin to set the Mysore Pak. Because once you make the mixture, you'll have to immediately pour it into the tin or a tray or a plate, whichever you're using to set the Mysore Pak, because it will start taking shape immediately, so you don't want to delay that process. So make sure you grease all the sides with enough ghee. So the remaining ghee, this is just about a teaspoon. I'm just going to pour it into the tin because the mixture will start absorbing the ghee while it's setting. So when you release it from the tin, it will come out nice and smooth. Now we'll start making the Mysore Pak. Next, I'm going to make the sugar syrup. For this, to the pan add 1/4 cup of water. For 1 cup of basin or gram flour, I've taken 1 cup of sugar. Once the sugar is completely dissolved, transfer the basin and ghee mixture into the pan. Keep the flame on low while doing this. So mix it all in, make sure everything is well combined. So now we're going to gradually start combining the ghee. So you can see the ghee gradually gets absorbed into the mixture. So continue to slow cook on low flame. So we'll be cooking this at least for about 10 minutes on low flame. So you can see the ghee is completely absorbed. So as the ghee is absorbed into the mixture, I'm going to add a little more. So the ghee is absorbed beautifully into the mixture. It's become nice and thick. You can see how easily it's sliding off. And it's just forming a mass. So this is the consistency that you want. Once you get this consistency, just transfer it into the prepared tin and let it set. Just finally going to add a little ghee on top. So I've let it sit for a couple of hours for the Mysore Pak to set. You can see it's absorbed all the ghee beautifully. Now let's release the side and take it out of the tin. So there you go, here is this wonderful ghee Mysore Pak. You can see how soft and rich it is. Now this is a very simple recipe. Make sure you follow all the steps and you will get it perfectly. Do try the recipe, share it with your family and friends and enjoy this festive season.